drunken chicks are sweethearts with your bloodshot eyes of blue. All you border crossing faglich who've been quarantined for flu. All you lost exilic aliens, you migrant mongrels too. You needn't feel verloren, you don't have to be blue. Just climb aboard this ark of ours and join the soggy crew. It's a diasporic politics, it's a reconstructed you. With permeable borders in between the old and new. A way to hide away what they would take away from you. Forget your God and country and your revolution too. It's possible for you to leave the many for the few. It don't matter if your daddy's from Poland or Peru. Your blood might come from Turkey or Detroit or Timbuktu. Your language could be Farsi, Sanskrit, German or Zulu. Come on, we've got some wandering to do. So bring out your Jew, bring out your Jew. You may have a Jew inside of you. A Jew, a secret little Jew. A secret Jew is buried inside you. Well, my definition here could use some explanation. True, you have to ask yourself just what I mean when I say Jew. Well, the Jewishness concerning us should not be misconstrued. Blood and land are things with which it doesn't have to do. Religion is a matter most irrelevant here too. So let us try to look at this anew. To find a category underneath the ones we knew. A mercurial identity for people who are strewn in countries far and wide who haven't got home in view. Who drag around like shackles all the roots from which they grew. Well, others have endured this illness too. And here I offer it all up to you. A kosher Yiddish food for thought that Goyim now can chew. It's what they did with Jesus when they wrote the Bible new. Rebranded monotheism for wider public view. So learn to take the rootless cosmopolitan worldview and the hidden interstices we all normally eschew. To schlep your gullis proudly, you must learn how to make do. And learn, learn, learn is what the wise man tells us to. So learn to be a Jew, learn to be a Jew. You may have a Jew inside of you. A Jew, I've read too much about you. A secret Jew is hiding inside you. Why should I put the emphasis on inner secret Jews? We all have different nations that we wear like different shoes. They carry us around so that our feet don't get too bruised. It may seem to be easier just to go out in the nude, to throw up our identities like half-digested food. So maybe it's reductive what I'm trying to pursue. I mean, it's philo-Semitism and a cheap semantic ruse. It's highly problematic, it will probably confuse. And what about us people who are actually Jews? With traumas all my deconstructed theories can't subdue. Just ask a gentle German for a history review. She'll tell you how they marked us with numerical tattoos. They turned us into ashes, hair and lamps and soap and glue. And no, it wasn't something that I personally knew. But they taught me all about it in my Temple Sunday school. And I guess it kind of left me with some hang-ups and taboos. How can we wear the mantle of the martyred ghetto Jews? We turned our backs on everything that brought our people through. Did it really work to try to make a new Hebrew? With the enemies we slew, the hatred grew and grew. But the thing you hate in others is the thing you hate in you. Now exile will return like deja vu. Where it all went wrong, nobody knew. And we will all have to learn it anew. Not only as a victim, but a perpetrator too. To learn to be a Jew, learn to be a Jew. Learn to be a post-Israeli Jew. A Jew, a Jew, the problem isn't new. You must be a Jew among the Jews. So when they ask you for your papers, and you don't know what to do, remember in this moment what you're carrying with you. Because the day will come when all your papers are refused, and then you'll find yourself in exile too. You're living in a land and time that aren't made for you. You're refugees from wars between religious points of view. And you schlep around like shackles all the roots from which you grew. So I talk about the inner other hiding inside you. The name I give this other is a Jew. But a Jew can be an Arab, or a German, or a Druze. So if you have a better name that you would like to use, well, I'd love to read the testament of you. The imaginary messianic diasporic you. The broken and neurotic post-apocalyptic you. See, I mean this as a question, not an answer to your blues. The question is the answer, and the answer it is you. And forgive the self-indulgence that I spew. See, I just wrote this fucking thing where every sentence rhymes with Jew. So bring out your Jew, bring out your Jew. You may have a Jew inside of you. A Jew, a secret little Jew. A secret Jew is buried inside you. The hour is getting late. Soon we'll have to pay our dues. We're faced with situations where we all have to choose. And no one will recover what we're all about to lose. And history is a river full of things we'll have to use. The world is turning colder, and the walls are high and true. And the cities all are burning into something dark and new. The fire and the waste have beat the heavens black and blue. And you're refugees from wars between religious points of view. And all the broken borders are the names they put on you. You're strangers in your home, even strangers sur la rue. Well, I have a little prophecy for you. An apocalyptic mystery, a clue. As the world becomes Detroit, we all become like Jews. When Zion is destroyed, the promise will come true. Detroit is all your cities, and Zion is in you. So learn to take it with you. Learn to be a Jew.